And right now on West 2 News at 6, a critical witness fills in the blanks in the timeline of a missing 2-year-old, Trenton Duckett. Exclusive information obtained tonight by the West 2 I team.
West 2 News was first to bring you information that a second witness, a second worker at a Marion County Wendy's restaurant, saw Trenton Duckett alive the day he disappeared. We have live team coverage right now. West 2's Kathy Marsh is at Team Trenton headquarters after an exclusive interview with Melinda Duckett's grandmother. But we start with I team reporter Stephen Stock, who's been working the story all day. And Stephen, why is this second witness's account so critical to this case?
Well, Jim, several law enforcement sources say it is critical because it compresses the timeline when Trenton Duckett was last seen alive and in his mother's care. And it's information first brought to you by West 2 News two nights ago. A source close to the investigation confirms that a second witness at the Wendy's in Bellevue says she saw Melinda Duckett on Sunday, August 27th, with her son Trenton, alive.
We are live at Team Trenton headquarters here at Leesburg, Florida.
After Nancy Grace's show on Trenton Duckett's case aired, authorities said they received as many as 100 tips and leads from around the country. So far, none have panned out, as well as the witness from Bellevue.
We're going to review every lead.
Although we wouldn't comment on the second witness at Wendy's, Major Chris Blair did say that any corroboration to the first witness is critical because it confirms that Trenton was alive on the morning he was reported missing.
So I think we needed to make sure that the public knows that there is a very good possibility that Trenton Duckett is alive.
But you have no evidence to support that as well. Indeed, it could be the other way.
That's correct.
Is there any way?
Grace's show explored several theories about what happened to Trenton, from possible abduction through the broken window screen on Melinda's apartment to an abandoned house south of Leesburg that turned out to be near Tampa.
It was a tip that came from a psychic out of state.
Even the private investigator working with Josh Duckett says most of the tips and theories are far-fetched. Even so, he wants them to keep coming in.
Team Trenton was formed because they felt that they needed to keep the notice and the attention out there.
And so all of this is good in that respect.
Correct.
Whether it's bogus or not, it's keeping this out there in the public.
Correct.
And Leesburg police have spent all day behind closed doors working these leads, dozens of them. The leads first go to Team Trenton on the website or by phone, then distributed to the FBI, the Marion County Sheriff, or the Leesburg Police Department. And I talked to the Leesburg police spokesman, Steve Rockefeller, who says right now the theory still holds that Trenton was with Melinda when he disappeared. That's the latest from Leesburg. I'm Stephen Stock, West 2 News.
A lot of new stuff. Thanks a lot, Stephen. It's been a busy month since Team Trenton headquarters opened in Leesburg. After Nancy Grace's show last night, volunteers saw a tremendous increase in the number of calls to their hotline. Phones rang late into the night. Since it opened, Team Trenton has fielded more than 2,000 calls, generating about 700 tips to check out on the search for Trenton.
Team Trenton also wants you to know about a second website set up to take tips and communicate with people following the case. This is a live look at the blog-style site. Team Trenton says it was designed as a place to post tips, messages of support, and questions for Trenton's family. To check out both Trenton sites, go to West.com and click under Scene on 2. West 2 reporter Kathy Marsh is the only local TV reporter to talk with Melinda Duckett's grandmother, Nancy Eubank. And Kathy, you spoke with her again today about the new evidence and the information in the search for Trenton. What does she have to say now?
Well, Jim, this is a woman who doesn't hold back. She has a lot to say. She talks, of course, lovingly about her granddaughter, Melinda, who she believes was driven to commit suicide from all the pressure. And she also talks about how she wants to do what she can to help find Trenton. Melinda Duckett's grandmother, Nancy Eubank, offers strong opinions on everything from taking a lie detector test to the new witness from the Wendy's Bellevue restaurant. That's the witness who claims she saw Melinda and Trenton together in the drive-thru in Melinda's car, and then 20 minutes later saw Melinda alone.
Perhaps she ordered something that wasn't in the bag when she got to wherever she was going to eat it. Maybe she came back for it. Or maybe she wanted something more after she thought about it. That's the only thought I would have on that. I don't think that's too odd.
Now that a new intensive 30-day task force to find Trenton has geared up, will Eubank take a lie detector test?
Would you be willing to take one?
I offered to take it when this all started. And in fact, I went, they did polygraph my husband. And I went with him that morning because I thought that I was going to have one too. And when I got there, they said, no, we just want to do one of you and we want to do him.
As Trenton's great-grandmother, Nancy loves and adores the child. As for where he is now...
Nancy, do you think in your heart and soul he is alive?
He probably is. If he's not, he's in heaven. But I can't think about somebody hurting him. But yes, I think he's alive.
And of course, that's the reason why we're here live tonight at Team Trenton headquarters, where Nancy Grace will once again broadcast her national show live this evening, all in an effort to do whatever she can to put the face of Trenton on TV and to get folks to call in or email in tips to help find this toddler who's been missing since August the 27th. Reporting live in Leesburg in Lake County, Kathy Marsh, West 2 News.
Kathy, thanks a lot. If you have any information on the Trenton Duckett case, you can call investigators at 1-888-FL-MISSING. You can remain anonymous and you could collect a cash reward. That's 1-888-FL-MISSING.